This is a large raft. It is the Blackfin 10 of Brunswick Marine. But today, I will speak of neither the sun deck nor of tubes. Today, we'll focus on the helm. Have you seen something powerful there in the stern? In fact, they fear, but we have everything it takes to tame them. Now we will focus on instrumentation, then unleash the horses. Mercury has built engines for almost 80 years, and now, more than ever, has developed products and brilliant ideas to get us boating more and more easily and pleasantly. There are no problems with the joystick to maneuver. We know it well. Mercury has developed it a few years ago, but now it has been improved further to make it easy to use from even the first time. With this command, you do not have to worry about getting to know what is the bow and the stern. What you want to move the boat in that direction? Well, you push the knob in that direction. You decide to make a lateral move. Here it is. It's a very difficult maneuver for any commander, but thanks to this system that allows you to operate the motors in an independent manner, it becomes easy. Observe, one motor is 1,500 RPM, and the other is at about 1,150, and the boat moves sideways. Of course, one is in reverse gear, and the other is in forward gear. And then there is the skyhook control, really comfortable. Here's a warning signal. Risk of being struck by the propeller. Okay. Confirm. It's telling you that right now the stern is keeping the boat at rest in place to counter the wind and current. You don't have to do anything. But the joystick can also be used in navigation. We engage the gears and use it as if we were in autopilot. Here, it follows the route, and if you want, you can set waypoints and make them automatically follow along with this button. If you decide to change your direction, just maybe 1 degree to the left, take a shot at this wheel on the side. A degree right, here you want to change the route more prominently, 10 degrees left, that's it, or 10 degrees to the right, that's it. Now I'll show you why the new Mercury piloting joystick is even more effective than previous ones. You should know that all outboard motors expel the exhaust gases through the propeller hub. This airflow inevitably pushes the boat forward, in contrast to the propeller action in reverse gear. But Mercury has solved the problem, letting out the exhaust gases only in reverse, over the anti-cavitation plate, thus leaving the propeller free to perform its function. This boat has 800 horsepower. It's frighteningly powerful. It could strike fear. How to handle all this power? How to adjust the structure of this lightning bolt? No problem, because Mercury invented active trim, a tool that automatically controls the throttle trim and which is also relatively cheap. Not only because it has a reasonable cost, but because it helps us to save fuel. We know that when we start, the propeller must push down a little to prevent the dinghy nose from raising too much. But then, when it's aligned, we must lift the trim progressively, depending on the speed. But with this system, you can do without thinking. The trim regulates automatically.
Automatically.
However, the more experienced boaters know that the structure also varies according to the load on board and the conditions we encounter, depending on how we face the sea, the waves, if they are tall, if they are short or quick. Well, Mercury thought that to solve this problem, active trim would have at least 5 different settings.
Almeno 5 diverse regolazioni. Eccole qua.
Here they are. The lowest, and we get a low trim. The highest, and it rises. Maybe when we want to go fast on flat water, like today, as here on the lake.
Su acque piatte come oggi, come qui sul lago. Mi pare piuttosto facile.
It seems pretty easy. Then the system is also smart because over 50 miles per hour it is deactivated because at certain speeds the driver must have total control of the vehicle. In any case, even if the active trim is running, as soon as action is taken on these keys here on the throttle, it switches off. Here it is flashing. It indicates precisely which is active, that off, and to return it to operate simply press the on and it brings the boat to the proper trim. Active trim is compatible with all Mercury smart craft engines, so with a wide range of outboard and stern drive engines, petrol, diesel and even racing, with power ratings from 40 to 1,650 horsepower. I always liked Mercury's electro-hydraulic steering for its control and accuracy, and now they have improved it further. It's not a simple servo-assisted system that serves to do hard work when turning. No, they have added feedback that allows the pilot to feel with his hands on the steering wheel, the reactions of the motors when we turn, or when we face a wave. And this serves to make us not exaggerate.
Affrontiamo un'onda, e questo serve per non farci esagerare.
Now, before we push this Blackfin 10 to the maximum, I still want to familiarize myself a little with the instruments. This monitor, for example, is called Vessel View, and it comes in a 5 or 7 inch version, always with a high resolution screen at 16 to 90, just like a TV in your home. It can control up to 4 monitors and interfaces with the latest generation of fish finders, the charts, camera, audio systems, AIS, automatic identification of other vehicles, and it has a built-in GPS, a micro SD slot that communicates via Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Crazy!
Pazzesco! Con questi motori, la barca o il gommone.
With these engines, the boat or raft does not matter. I mean, the Blackfin 10 is 10 meters long, weighs 2.5 tons, then we must add all the load. But it is as if there was nothing. It seems to me to be sitting on the engine, with nothing under my feet. This engine defies the laws of gravity. That thrust, it's the most powerful mass-produced outboard engine in the world. It has the best weight-to-power ratio than any other marine engine, 1.32 horsepower per kilogram, because it is very light, weighing just 303 kilograms. And they have managed to achieve this thanks to the fact that it has a low capacity, and the power is then obtained with a volumetric compressor, and with a very high speed, up to 7,000 RPM. Even the power density is the highest in its class, 153 horsepower to the litre. To take advantage of every drop of fuel is a fuel injection system called Multiforce, controlling the stoichiometric ratio in each chamber. It was developed in Mercury Factory Racing, and because of this, it has a head, pistons, connecting rods, camshaft, special. But what interests us is the performance. Cruising speed, 4,800 RPM, 40 knots. And from this moment, that something begins to change. Yes, plus the RPMs jump, and the more it seems I am sitting on a racing motor.
Su un motore da corsa.
This craft was not made to run fast. It has a large area, a lot of fiberglass, a cabin. Well, in short, it's not built for speed.
Mezzo da velocità, eppure.
Yet, 58, 59 knots.
59 nodi.
This engine is like winning the lottery. Yes, because working hard, maybe you have to earn €1 million. But to have them all go at once, well, that's another thing. Here, to have 400 horses, you can also put two engines of 200 horsepower. But to have them all in one shot, it's another thing.